my teammate is Umang Barbaya. So today we are going to give a short demonstration on our end term project, which is implementation of pick stack in a dockerized environment. So tick stack is a platform of various type of tools that are open source, mainly used for collection, storing, graphing and handling of time series data very quickly. Tick stands for multiple components in the platform. They are Telegraph, InfluxDB, Chronograph and Capacitor. Each component of the tick stack can provide significant value as it is interoperable. The InfluxDB is a time series database that has a very high performance. Telegraph is a collection agent for metrics that are used for sending and collecting metrics to the Influx database. The UI of the tick stack is Chronograph, which is used for setting up a database of data in Influx database. Capacitor is a metrics that processes events and also works as alerting engine. The primary purpose of Capacitor is to crunch the time series data into actionable alerts. Briefly, data are sent to Telegraph, then it is stored in the InfluxDB database. Through a web page, Chronograph will query the database, then processing, monitoring, and raising alerts are done by the Capacitor. Here, we need to create a Docker Compose file and use it to run and handle all the combinations of Telegraph, Influx database, Chronograph, and Capacitor. Now let me give a short description of the Docker Compose file. The Docker Compose file consists of all the four components of the stack and establishes the process of how they communicate with each other. Here we can see that there is Chronograph, Telegraph, Capacitor, and Influx database. So it has a network named VCC test network. This network is created for communication between the containers of the application. Since the Chronograph is the user interface of the tick stack and we need to have persistent storage, this persistent storage will be used to store the certificates. Now, going to the environment variables. Environment variables are very necessary for the components Chronograph and Capacitors. We need to set up the certificate and private key for Chronograph. They are set as selected here. We also need to set the URL for Influx database configuration group. We can do it by adding the environment. This as selected as Influx Capacitor, Influx Database, URLs as Influx :8086. Now let us go to the steps demonstration to implement the tick stack in dockerized environment. First of all, let me go through the files. This is the folder where we have, this is the folder where we have our files. It has a docker compose.yaml file, which I have already explained before. And there is a certificate file, which consists two certificates and a key file. Now, let me go to the, open the terminal and demonstrate the implementation. First of all, we need to provide the root access. So sudo -i provides the root access. After providing the password, then we need to go to the directory by changing it. The folder is under home/umang/desktop/ we have gone to the folder name. Now what we need to do is we need to copy the docker compose yaml file and remove these lines that is in this folder. this is suppose this is the Docker. We have uploaded this file in our GitHub. So we need to remove these three lines, that is environment, and these three selected lines. Then after that, what we need to do is we need to build the Docker by writing the command docker icon compose up minus t build. Since we have already built it, so I'm just going to run this command. After running this, we can see that these all components are up to date. Now the next step is we need to go to the link that is here. We need to go to this link 192.168.56.100:800 in our host browser. Let me refresh it. Then we can see that the TickStack platform has been opened. Now what we need to do is we need to create the influx database creation. Now after that, we need to provide the HTTPS certificate. For that, we need to make create a certificate directory by providing this mkdir certificate. Since we have already made this, so I'm not writing this command again. Then we need to navigate to the certificate directory. Then after that, we need to we know that we are not using any public domain, so we need to create the self-generated certificates, which are done using the using this command open ssh req hyphen new key RSA colon certificate.pem. After doing this command, the certificates will be generated. I'm not doing this because we have already created that certificate. Then we need to go back to the same directory. Then we need to provide the access to that certificate by writing this command chmod hyphen r 777 certificate. So what it does is it provides the access to the certificate file. Then after that, what we need to do is we need to again add those three lines that we have previously deleted. That is, these three lines must be added to this docker.compose.yaml file. Then after that, we need to provide this command docker-compose down. It will stop all these components. Now we again need to compose that file by writing this command. Now what we need to do is we again need to visit the link in our host browser, where we can find the SSL security which has been added. This is sorry here we can see that this link has been linked. We can open it, and let's like we have to go. Okay, now I would like to hand over to Umang for further explanation.
Hello, good evening, guys. Now coming to this, since we have given the HTTPS security, as we can see here, which is generated our own keys, as explained by Dipinti. Now let's do some data connection with the capacitor and telegraph.conf file. So first, we need to run this command, docker exec -it. So this we are doing actually basically updating the telegraph.conf file for data for capacitor connections with the data. /bin/bash. I'm running this. Let me update it. apt update. After that, I can do apt install nano. Now I need to update the file /etc/telegraph/telegraph.conf. Need to go to the below line, and for this influxdb I need to remove this URL and comment it. And in this path, I need to write influxdb, which we had given in our configuration file. And after that, I need to also uncomment this database file. Now I need to this control X. Now I saved it. Once this is done, let me just run docker compose up. Oops, just first exit. Docker compose up /d. It is saying which is up to date. Now what I do is I just create my connection host over there, influxdb. We can provide password security also. We add a connection. We need to search for a dashboard system. We created one dashboard. Now over here I need to write capacitor. Then I can give password over here if we need it. We do continue. We can see all the connections over here. We go to host list, it is the host form. The system has been created over here, so this will update. So first, before that, we need to reboot our machine. So we'll just join them. Since our system has been rebooted, we have written docker compose up -d. And now if we can see our one host is connected. Now if I can go to my dashboard and if I click on system, I see the various parameters that has been used by our system. With our system metrics, we can see like the system memory, disk IO, swap and net measurements can be found over here. Now this was pretty much the working of the tick stack. Now let's give another form of security by giving an alert. So we can go to a manage task, where we can click over here, build alert rule. We can give some rule as test rule 1, and we can give some filters like usage pin id underscore id. We first selected this over here, filter, then we can we need to select the database, and then we select the CPU. Then we can select our usage underscore ID. Once this is done, I can select over here is less than, suppose 99. Now I need to save this rule. Once this is done, if I can go to alert is created, and I need to go to alert history. We just refresh it and wait for some time. When alert pops up, see one alert has pop up, since it's the value was 98.1, which was less than 99. So that was the pretty much complete the project, NSM project that we had discussed earlier, which was given by the sir. And I wish, like, thank you everyone.